In 1959, Nobel laureate Richard Feynman presented an idea of building materials atom by atom, and this idea evolved into a new branch of science, which is called as nanoscience. So, a nanoscience deals with building up complex materials and machines using fine control on the matter at the nanometer scale. So, in nanoscience, we'll be studying properties of the materials having the length scale of the order of few nanometers. Here is some comparison of sizes of different objects. A ball diameter can be measured in centimeters. Size of an ant can be measured in millimeters. Diameter of a hair around 100 micrometers. Size of a blood cell around 10 micrometers. Bacteria around 1 micrometer. Virus around 100 nanometers. DNA around 10 nanometers. Size of the molecules is around 1 nanometer. An atom is around angstroms, measured in angstroms, that is 0.1 nanometer. So, in nanotechnology, we will deal with the materials in this size range, 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer. So, the materials having the size of this order will be studied in the nanoscience. To study the nanomaterials, we will need some tools and techniques that will be used for preparing the nanomaterial, for characterization of the nanomaterials, and using the properties of nanomaterials in different applications. These tools and techniques involved in the preparation of nanomaterials, characterization of nanomaterials, and using the properties of nanomaterials in different applications are collectively called as nanotechnology. So, in nanotechnology, we are going to study the tools and techniques used for preparing the nanomaterials, characterization of nanomaterials, and using their properties in different applications. Electron microscopes will be very important tools in the nanotechnology. Because nanoparticles are very small in size, we will not be able to see them with our eye, or even very high resolving power microscope, optical microscope, will not be able to show the nanoparticles to us. So, we will need a very high resolving power microscope, and such microscopes are called as electron microscope. So, in nanotechnology, we will be extensively using this electron microscope. So, in this sessions, we will be discussing the construction and working of some of the electron microscopes, scanning electron microscope, transmission electron microscope, and atomic force microscopes we will be getting introduced to. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.